In this video, I'll say more about self-similarity. So first, just a reminder that self-similarity means that an object is made up of smaller copies of itself. So it looks the same at different scales. And moreover, this self-similarity continues across many scales. So it's not just like, oh, here's a big thing, there's one little copy in it. But the idea is that it repeats, that you've got a big shape made up of little shapes, that shape is made up of little shapes, that shape is made up of little shapes, and so on. And mathematically, strictly speaking, for a fractal, that behavior continues forever. As you keep zooming in onto a shape, a mathematical fractal, you see more and more of the same shape. The Koch curve is an example. As you keep zooming in, if this had infinite resolution and could focus in, you would keep seeing that same shape repeating again and again. Okay, so fractals, objects that are self-similar, are often said to be scale-free. They don't have a sense of length or a typical scale or size associated with them. So let me illustrate that a couple of different ways. So in science and in everyday life, the scale or size of something usually is one of the first things we think about. So for example, tomatoes. It's the end of the summer here in the Northern Hemisphere, and we have just a couple more weeks, maybe a month, of getting tomatoes from our tomato plants. So this is a tomato I picked from my garden this morning, and tomatoes have a particular size. You might have a tomato that's a bit smaller than this. Certainly you have tomatoes that are larger than this. This isn't a giant tomato. But it would be pretty rare to have a tomato that's larger than 2 pounds or a kilogram. And there are smaller tomatoes. There's this little cherry tomato that I picked this morning. And this is about as small as tomatoes get. So the point is that there's a typical size associated with tomatoes. Tomatoes, there's sort of an average size, and then a few larger, a few smaller. We don't have all different sizes of tomatoes. We don't have microscopic tomatoes. We don't have tomatoes as big as me, as big as a house, as big as a whale, and so on. Okay, so tomatoes have a scale. So if I, another way to think about that is, if I wanted to indicate the size of something else, I could put a picture of a tomato, I could put a tomato next to it, and you would know, oh, it's about tomato size, because tomatoes have a size. Okay, in contrast, for fractals, here's a Sierpinski triangle again, they don't have a characteristic size. What's the typical size of a triangle in a Sierpinski, in the Sierpinski triangle? Well, they're triangles of all different sizes. That's sort of the point, as we've seen. As we zoom in more and more, we keep seeing more and more triangles. And mathematically, that would go on forever. So they're triangles of all different sizes. And that's a very different situation than with the tomatoes, where tomatoes come in a pretty narrow range of sizes. All right, here's another way to think about this. So again, if something is scale-free, there aren't clues as to its size. A tomato is a clue as to size, but a triangle and a Sierpinski triangle is not. So here's another way to think about that. Suppose that one morning you woke up and you had been shrunk. You were suddenly much smaller than you were before. Maybe you were the size of this guy now. That would be a horrible thing to think about. Hopefully you at least still have two arms. All right, so suppose you get shrunk down like this. Well, you would know right away that you were small, because your bed would be gigantic, a tomato could feed you for a week, you would be as big as your cat could be a danger to you. There are all sorts of clues as to size in the most aspects of the world in which we navigate. So you could tell right away that we had been that you had been shrunk. On the other hand, imagine, and this takes a little bit of imagination, but imagine you lived inside a Sierpinski triangle, not our world, not our normal world, but a fractal world like this. So this world consists of triangles and triangles and triangles. And as we've seen, every time you sort of double the size, you get three times as many triangles. So triangles within triangles within triangles. If you lived in this world and you were shrunk one morning all of a sudden, you wouldn't be able to tell. There's no sense of scale here. There's not a typical tomato or a cat or a bed or a pillow. It's just the world is triangles and triangles and triangles. Maybe you can also think about if you lived in a tree that went on forever, that had branches that got bigger and bigger and bigger and branches that got smaller and smaller and smaller, you wouldn't be able to tell what size you were. All you know is that there are branches that have this relationship that holds across all of these different scales. So that's another way to think about what it means for something to be scale-free and one of these consequences of shapes that are self-similar.